Hello children, welcome to our maths class. Today we are going to start our new lesson, capacity. Capacity means it is the amount of container that hold. Amount of container it can hold. It refers to the internal volume of the container. Okay, how much the container can hold, that is the capacity. Okay, first we will read the Shekho story, then you can understand it. Shekho bought milk from a milkman every day. However, he felt that the milkman often gave him less milk. Shekho wanted to check the quantity of the milk. Okay, the Shekho is thinking the milkman is giving him a very less, often he is giving the less quantity of the milk. That's why he want to check the quantity of the milk. Then Shekho shared the problem with his friend Maya. She told him for a few days use a bowl to measure the milk. She gave this bowl as a standard unit to measure the milk. Now he used the same bowl and he started counting the milk. First day on Monday, there is a 5 bowl milk. Milkman given him a 5 bowl milk. Then second day on Tuesday, again he count the milk which milkman has given him, then that is of 5 bowl. On third day it is of 4 bowl. On fourth day, on Thursday, it is of 3 bowl. Means there is a difference in the quantity of the milk. Whatever the milkman is given, there is a difference between the quantity of the milk. Okay, do you think that the milkman was giving him equal quantity of the milk every day? No, there is a change in the quantity of the milk. Yes, you can observe here. You can see here. There is a difference in the quantity of the milk. Then on fifth day, what he has done? Let's see. On the fifth day, Shekho discussed the situation with the milkman. He gave a similar bowl to the milkman and asked him to use that to measure milk every day. Shekho gave him a bowl as a standard unit to measure the milk. Now the milkman and Shekho had similar bowl to measure the milk with. They started to consider it as a standard unit to measure the milk for themselves. This bowl they are using as a standard unit to measure the milk. Pick a standard unit for your class and measure the capacities of various containers. You may pick a bowl, glass or cup as the standard unit. Container to be measured, a big glass or a bottle. Here I am having a glass, bottle, and I am using this bowl as a unit. Okay, let's do the activity. This is my container to be measured and this is my unit. One bowl water. One bowl water fill more than half the glass. Let's do with the second bowl of the water. See here. Means the quantity of the container. Here half bowl of water is remaining. Okay. Means to fill this glass, one and half bowl of water we required. Let's record your answer. Here container we used a big glass and we use the unit as a bowl. We use a bowl as a unit. Okay. Now how much capacity is there for one glass? One and half bowl required to fill one glass. Let's do with the bottle. One bowl of water. Let's see how much bowl of water required to fill this bottle. Let's do. One bowl. This one is the second bowl. This is the third bowl. This one is the fourth bowl. This one is the fifth bowl. Half bowl of water again here remain. Means total how many bowl of water required? Total 4.5 bowl required to fill the bottle. Let's record the answer. Total 4.5 bowl required to fill the bottle. Here you can see there is a difference in the capacities according to their container. That's why we cannot measure the accurate measurement with the help of these units. The other examples you have to do at your home by using the different pot or mug or jug. Measure with the your bowl and record your answer here. That also you have to do with your bowl, whatever you are having at your home. Then all answer will be different. Then record here. Then you can understand there is a difference between the capacities according to the different container. That's why we cannot use these things as a unit to measure the capacity. After a few months, the milkman moved to a new place and Shekhu hired a new milkman. Again, he felt the new milkman was giving him less milk. Can there be a permanent solution to Shekhu's problem? Yes. Do all people measure liquid using bowl? No, we cannot use. Here we have discussed why we cannot use bowl as a standard unit. Okay, because there is a difference in all answers. Okay, all capacities. How do petrol pumps measure petrol when they fill in your car? Yes, they use the standard unit like liter, 1 liter petrol, 5 liter, 10 liter petrol, like this they are giving us. Let's see the standard unit. The standard unit to measure the length is kilometer, and centimeter also we have learnt in our length lesson. Okay, the standard unit to measure the weight is, yes, kilogram, kg. Okay, similarly the standard unit to measure the volume of the liquid or the capacity of the container is liter. Liter is the standard unit of the liquid. Spelling L-I-T-R-E, liter. It is also written as L, liter. Okay. Gather various wrappers and read the units on them in your class. What is the unit written on the packets having solid such as pulses? Let's see. Here I am having the salt pocket. Let's see here. It is written net weight 1 kg. Okay. It was written 1 kg. Means weight we are measuring in kg. What is the unit written on the packets having liquid such as oil, fruit juices? See here, I am having the oil. And the unit written on it is, you can see, 300 ml. Okay, milliliter, 300 ml means milliliter, 300 milliliter. Here I am having the floor cleaner. Let's read the unit written on that. Here you can see it is written net volume 1 liter. 1 liter. Yes, capacity we measure in the liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Okay, capacity we measure in the liter. Here, net volume 1 liter. Here, I arrange these liquids in the ascending order. Okay. Here you can see this is the tonic bottle of 200 ml. This is the oil bottle of 300 ml. This is sanitizer bottle of 500 ml. 500 ml, and this is the floor cleaner of 1 liter. Okay, that's why the standard unit to measure the capacity is liter. Okay, prepare a web chart in your notebook and write the name of the things, names of the things that you can measure in liter. Here you can prepare the chart. Things I can measure in liter. Here one example is given, water. Then what will come here again? Petrol. Again, which thing you are measuring? Oil. Again, milk. Again, curd. Again, fruit juice. That you can write here. Okay. Next. Like this you can write, or you can write by your own also. Now next. How much do you think is a liter? Collect 1 liter bottle and fill them using the standard unit. Cup, bowl or glass. You had decided in your class. I have decided bowl as a standard unit. Then count this 1 liter is equal to how much bowl. How many bowl? Let's do. Here I am having the 1 liter capacity jar. And this is the bowl. Okay. How much bowl required to fill this 1 liter jar, that we have to do. This activity you have to do at your home. Let's do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can observe here, it fills till here, till the mark. Means 5 bowl are required to fill this 1 liter jar. Okay. 5 bowl I required, bowl I required to fill the 1 liter jar. Okay. Now, observe some other measuring cups which can also be used to measure a liter. I will show you. This is also used as a 1 liter jar. This is also used as a 1 liter. This is also used as a 1 liter. These are the different measuring cups. Now, this is for your homework. Here you have to write down name of the object which you measure in kg, centimeter and liter. Now here, how much water is there in the container, that you have to write down here by this marking. You have to write down here. Then in this measuring jar, color to show the given capacity. Here the capacity is given 9 liter. Then you have to color till here with this blue color. You have to complete this. Bring a 1 liter bottle or measuring jar to your class. Find out the capacities of various utensils and record their measurement. Here you can take the pot, casserole, bucket, jug, mug, and then capacities in liter. That's why you have to require the 1 liter. For that you have to require the 1 liter capacity jar. For this you require like this capacity jar at your home. Here you can see, children, it is mentioned here 100 ml, 200 ml, 300 ml, 400 ml. 1 liter means the 1000 ml. 1 liter means 1000 ml. Okay. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. This you require at your home. Okay. And half liter means, you can see here, 500 ml. This is the 500 ml. Okay. Like this you require at home. 500 ml. Means 1 liter. Keep one thing in your mind. 1 liter means 1000 ml. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. ml means milliliter. ml means milliliter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Okay, and here half liter means half liter is equal to 500 ml. Half of this means 500 ml. Half of the 1000 is 500. 500 ml is half liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml and half liter is equal to 500 ml. Find out 1 liter bottle or measuring jar at your home and do the homework. This is for homework. Use a 1 liter bottle or a container available at your home to measure the capacity of various utensils. Record the finding in your notebook. You have to solve this question with the help of this table. Record your answer according to this, and you have to do this activity like this. Use here, you can use here, like pot, jug, mug, casserole, anything you can write, and use this 1 liter jar and record the capacities of this. Okay? Means, for example, if you are using here jug, then how much liter it required to fill it, to fill this jug by using this measuring jar. How much liter it requires to fill this, that you have to record here. Okay? Hope, children, you all have understood the concept of liter and capacities. We will meet in our next session. Till that time, have a nice day. Goodbye. Thank you, children.